Hi friends, welcome back. Our today's topic is simplification. As we know, simplification is one of the very important topic for all kind of competitive exams, let it be bank, SSC, railway, UPSC, CSAT and placement trainings. In all the exams, minimum 2 to 3 questions will be asked. If we talk about bank and SSC, more than 5 to 6 questions from simplification will appear in exam. So today I have taken 2 questions which has been asked in UPSC CDS 2017 exam. See, UPSC CDS exam is conducted for the recruitment in Army, Air Force and Navy for the officer post. So I am going to discuss short tricks to solve this kind of questions quickly in the exam. My question is, if x to the power 6 plus 1 by x to the power 6 is equals to k into x square plus 1 by x square, then k is equals to which value? So you have to basically find out the value of k. So we will go by option elimination method. See, if you want the value of k, then which value you will keep it here? See, if you will keep x square minus 1 plus x square, if option a if you will keep, then what will happen? You see, then if you will multiply x square to x square, then the maximum power you will get is what? X to the power 4. But in the question they are asking you, if x to the power 6 plus 1 by x to the power 6 is equals to k into multiplied by x square. That means you don't need the maximum power of x is x square. You need what? X to the power 4. So x to the power 4, when it will get multiplied with x square, it will give you x to the power 6, and then this equation will be correct. So option A is eliminated. Now we have 3 options. Out of this, one option will be correct. Now let's go for the other option. So your question is, x to the power 6 plus 1 divided by x to the power 6 is equals to k into x square plus 1 by x square. Now put the value of x is equals to 1. So if you'll put the value of x is equals to 1, then here it will be 1 plus 1 by 1 is equals to k into 1 plus 1 by 1. So basically it will be 1 is equals to k, sorry, 1 plus 1 is 2 is equals to k into 2, k, 2, 2 cancel, the value of k will be 1. Now put the value of x is equals to 1 in the equation and see where you are getting k is equals to 1, because the value of k only you have to find it out, right? Then k is equals to. So equation 2, you see, if you are putting the value of x is 1, so 1 minus 1 plus 1. So yes, here you are getting 1. Now in option C, 1 plus 1 plus 1, it will give you 3. Now option C is wrong. I want the value of k is equals to 1. Option 4, you see, so 1 minus 1 minus 1, you are getting minus 1. But the value of k is what? When we are putting the value of x is equals to 1, then we are getting k is equals to 1. Same thing we applied here. When we are putting the value of x is equals to 1, we should get k is equals to 1, which only option B is giving us. So option B will be the correct answer for this question. So if you want to solve this question, it will maximum take 10 seconds, because you will directly put the value of x, two options will be eliminated, and one option by seeing only you can eliminate, because k value, if it will be x square, and if you multiply with x square, it will give you only x to the power 4, but you want what? X to the power 6. Let's understand question number 2 and try to solve. This is also asked in UPSC CDS 2017. The highest 4 digit number which is divisible by each of the numbers 16, 36, 45 and 48 is. So this also we will solve by option only. See, before that, one thing we'll see, 45 is a multiple of 9, 16 is a multiple of 4, right? So these two is important to solve this question. Now you see, there are 4 options are there, A, B, C, D, and they're asking which value is, and what they're asking is the highest 4 digit number which is divisible by all the 4 numbers, right? Okay, so if any number is divisible by 9, then what should be criteria? See, why I am searching for if any number is divisible by 9, because 45 is a factor of 9. So if a number is divisible by 45, then it should be divisible by 9 also. So divisibility rule of 9 is what? The digital sum of the number should be 9. And what is digital sum? Digital sum is nothing but sum of digits. So let's see option 1. Option 1, Digital sum will be what? 8 plus 1. Digital sum, how do you calculate? 9180. So 9 plus 1 plus 8. So 9 plus 1 is 10 and 10 plus 8 is 18. And 18 is what? Divisible by 9. So option A may be our answer. Now check option B. 6 plus 3 is 9. 9 plus 9 is 18. So again 18 is divisible by 9. Right, digital sum should be divisible by 9, right? Digital sum of a number should be divisible by 9. So you see, again, this is also divisible by 9. Third one, you see 6 plus 3 is 9, 9 plus 9 is 18. So again, digital sum is 18, or you can say 9, which is divisible by 9. So this also may be your answer. Option 4, 8 plus 4 is 12, 12 plus 9 is 21, and 21 is not divisible by 9. So option D is rejected, right? Okay, now let's go for the 16. So 16 means the multiple of, it should be a multiple of 4, right? So let's see. See, 80 is divisible by 4, 60 is also divisible by 4, but 30, see, divisibility rule of 4. What is divisibility rule of 4? The last two digit should be divisible by 4. So you see option 3, 30 is not divisible by 4, so option C is also rejected. Now I have two options, 9180 and 9360. Out of these two, one will be answer. So we know 16, the maximum multiple near to this number will be what? 9600. So 9600 is what? Divisible by 16. If you see 9180, then 9180 will be how much less? 10 minus 8 is 2, and 5 minus 1 is 4. And this, if you'll see, 0, 10 minus 6 is 4, and 5 minus 3 is 240. So 9180, option A is 420 less than 9600, and B is what? 240 less than 9600. So now you see which one is divisible by 16. 420 is divisible by 16. 16 into 2 is 32, 01. So 420 is not divisible by 16. Now you see 240 is divisible by 16. 16 into 1 is 16. So 80, 16 into 5 is 80. So 240 is divisible by 16. That means our answer will be what? Option B. See what I did? I just know the divisibility rule of 9, 4 and 16. And using that, I was able to solve this question. Otherwise, what you have to do? We have to take the LCM of this number. You have to take the LCM of this number. And after taking the LCM, you have to see which option is divisible by that LCM. I hope you understood the question and the trick. Thanks a lot for watching the video.